you starting the second half. Thank you all for coming and for listening. For all those people out there, yay, hi. I should go a little more formal. So the next piece is, I've always loved the aria, the opera, Bohemus Folly. I'm kind of testing myself because I am the hyperactive, head over heels, hopeless romantic. It's my life. Yes. So this next piece is called Tornami a Dire. It is a duet between Ernesto and Norina. It's at the very latter part of the opera. There's this whole convoluted story, essentially, of her being married to somebody else, but she loves Ernesto, and as operas do in happy times, they get together again. They have a moment of love. And this is their moment of love. The inspiration of this is, besides I love it, I met my lady Victoria a little over 3 years ago, and we met as I was hired back to my old college to sing a role in the Enthroned Masculine Sarai. If you don't know the opera, watch the movie Amadeus. It is the opera that Mozart asks the Kaiser. He says, what did you think about it? And he said, it's good, but too many notes, just cut out a few. And he said, no, there are just enough notes as needed for every, and he argued it, and he won somehow. But nonetheless, we were love interest, and it segued into a beautiful, flourishing romance, and I am honored to share it with you guys today. This is our first love duet. No pressure. Welcome, Victoria and Alvin.
Thank you.
But she had these two pieces. Two of my students had some vocal and I picked them out. And the other one is Heart, We Will Forget It. And they were for a competition to get judged and to get better. And through coaching both Patricia and my other student, Julia, I just fell in love with these pieces. But I watched them grow as artists and by my help, and not even about me, but to be able to impart such knowledge and feel so happy that not only did my one student get the high score out of this, out of an entire high school, which is, as a freshman, is pretty fantastic. My other student is a bit younger, she just turned 13, but Julia is just completely enamored with classical music. And she went from singing a pop song to Soltec song. And if you don't read, it's just a delightful piece. And I told her, going, that seems really great, let me do it. And she's taller than me, I should mention, so I should refer to this. But Bellmucker, she sang the second piece, Heart, We Will Forget Him. Heart, We Will Forget Him. And it is the second time in my existence on this earth that I've been brought to tears by how beautiful and how emotionally connected, which I always impart to my students, have some idea, which we're supposed to be artists, and we have many artists here today, which I'm flattered to be in your presence. And I sat there and tears just came from my eyes, and from a 12-year-old, which is to have that depth. And the other one has just, you know, sat down from that wonderful duet. So in my life, I've heard some great people. The last piece of the set is called O Cool is the Valley. When I started my journey as a singer, my first main teacher at college and undergrad at Mercer College, a gentleman named Stephen Mullen. This gentleman had one of the most ridiculously large voices I've ever heard in my life. Just blew my mind. Italian, just sentiment pouring all over, had just a great vision of things, and switched out the teaching for many reasons. And this piece is by James Joyce, the words are. And I hated James Joyce when I heard it. And I really hate him, just rambled on. And then I saw my friends and loved ones will know now that unfortunately I have become that, the stream of consciousness. And it is very weird to wake up and go, oh dear Lord, maybe I should do that. Because my mind's always running everywhere. So that's the other piece. He was a very large force to my love and passion for music. And he's also the composer, as well as conducting and Italian and many other things. So those are the three pieces coming up in succession, but wanted to give you a little bit, again, the whole concept is inspiration. I've been part of this, and want to share that with you. So this is my next section of English. Why do they shut me out of heaven? singing one of my absolute favorite artists called Ame Zani from La Fille du Regiment, or The Daughter of the Regiment. The short synopsis of this one, which I'm not traditioning this afternoon and that shows, is a wonderful opera about Marie Antonio, portraying Antonio. Antonio is in love with Marie. Now, Marie, on the other hand, was brought up in the military, really odd at that time, especially. So he runs into her, they fall in mad love, and can't marry her because he's not part of the regiment. And the gentlemen are all essentially father figures, so no, this is not going to happen. So, as it segues into this, he went, okay, well, I'll join the military, and I get to marry you. Very good. Okay, I can march. Yay. So that's about where we are with this one. It's very noted because it is, well, I just sing the Raptors forever. So if you will indulge me, I will share my last piece this evening for you. Ame Zani.
Ame Zani, then you're sure to know the pain.
finally happening, and we shall see if waiting like a banshee on pitch will get me work in a foreign country. I bet you can be very simple down to earth and not propose anything good about it this time. But God bless you all. Thank you for all of those who come. And when you can get treats, all of you have not. I'm sorry, we can send you recipes if you want. Victoria will send them promptly. So God bless you. Thank you. Good night to my virtual people. I love you all.